Hello, my name is Arno Smets. I'm professor in Photovoltaics, Materials and Devices Group at Delft University of Technologies. Welcome to the fourth course in our MicroMaster series, Solar Energy Engineering. The fourth course is called Integration of Photovoltaic Systems in Microgrids. In this course, you will learn about various aspects of AC and DC microgrids. The lecturers for this course will be Professor Pavel Bauer, Assistant Professor Laura Ramirez, both from the group DC Systems Energy Conversion and Energy Storage, and Seyamadit Izatkast, lecturer at our university. Our course on the integration of photovoltaic systems in microgrids is divided into five parts. After a short introduction, the first 2 weeks will address the definition components and layouts of microgrids. In week 3, we will discuss power electronic interfaces in microgrids. Then in week 4 and 5, we will look into the control, which is seen as the heart of a microgrid. In week 5, we focus on the emerging DC microgrids and discuss the potential benefits that can be obtained from the DC technology. In week 7 and 8, we discuss protection schemes within microgrids and finish the course with an overview of demonstration sites. Let's now go through all of these five sections in a bit more detail. The first 2 weeks are all about the definitions, components, and layouts of the microgrids. We may ask ourselves why the topic of microgrids has recently attracted a lot of attention from industry and the academia. The key point to answer this question is that microgrids are seen as the main building blocks of the future sustainable smart grids. In other words, to achieve large-scale grids, we have to properly build them up from the micro level. You will learn about the three general grid levels, where our focus is on the microgrid level. You will learn about the definition of a microgrid and the different microgrid scales. We will also discuss the main differences between a microgrid and a virtual power plant. You will learn about the advantages, disadvantages, and characteristics of the components in microgrids, which can be based on non-renewable sources like diesel or based on renewable energy sources like solar and wind. We also focus on different characteristics of the energy storage technologies, their optimal sizing and integration in microgrids. We will look into the various layouts of microgrids based on AC, DC or combinations of both technologies, and we will compare the performance of several layouts based on the efficiency criteria. In the second part, we will discuss the power electronics interfaces. We will discuss all combinations of AC and DC power electronics interfaces. You will learn about various interfaces in AC and DC microgrids for renewable generation components, non-renewable components, and energy storage components. In the third part of the PV4X course, we will discuss the control aspects of microgrids. We will look into the intelligent local controllers and microgrid controllers and discuss the primary, secondary, and tertiary control. You will be introduced to various types of power converters, and we will discuss the implementation of the frequency and voltage droop controllers. You will also learn about the communication schemes at different levels and the relevant standards for microgrids. We will wrap up the third part with the centralized versus decentralized control in microgrids. We will discuss the stability in the presence of distributed generators and their potential impact on the power quality and the continuity of electricity supply from the microgrids. To ensure this continuity, we discuss the Icelandic and Black Star process for microgrids. We finish this part with the ancillary services demand response and potential business models for microgrids. In the fourth session of this course, we will particularly focus on the DC microgrids. We will discuss the DC technology and compare the DC electronic transformer with its AC counterpart. You will also learn about the DC standards and application in real life. We also discuss in detail the single and multiple DC buses for monopolar, homopolar and bipolar topologies to which photovoltaic systems are connected. In the final section of this course, we will look into the protection examples and demonstration sites for microgrids. You will learn about the protection in microgrids, including the electronically interfaced distributed generators or the induction electrical machines that typically have very different fault currents. We will provide a good overview of the various available protection methods. We will introduce fault current sources and current limiters in different locations of the microgrid. Then we will analyze these faults outside the microgrid at the upstream network and compare them to the faults inside the microgrid, introducing adaptive control schemes. Finally, you will learn about the existing operational AC and DC demonstration sites around the world for off-grid or many other applications. Now the assessment. All the video content in this course, as well as numerous upgraded practice assignments, are available for free. These exercises are meant to test and improve your understanding of the concepts discussed in the videos, so try the exercises and don't be afraid to make any mistakes. By upgrading to the verified learner experience, you will get access to all exercises, the practice and graded assignments and exam questions. All the weekly graded assignments combined count for 40% towards your final grade. There are a total of 3 exams in the course which count for 60% towards your final grade. You can qualify for the PV4X verified certificate by achieving a minimal final score of 60%. New in this course are the microgrid control assignments. In these assignments, you will be able to play with different components, controls, and protection methods in a microgrid. The microgrids are built in Simulink, which is a MATLAB plug-in. As a result of the support we receive from MATWorks, a free license to MATLAB Online, including Simulink and Simscape, is available for the PV4X students. The microgrid control assignments are graded as regular assignments and will greatly help to better understand and visualize the interactions that occur in microgrids. Besides the regular content, PV4X also features a live webinar in which you can interact live with the course team. The webinar generally includes a behind-the-scenes tour at the TU Delft, an interview with a titan of the industry, and an interactive discussion in which the course team treats the issues introduced by the students. Look for more information in the webinar tab of the introduction and extras section. On behalf of the entire DC systems, energy conversion and storage team here at Delft University of Technology, I'm very excited to provide you this course. I hope you're ready to go, jump right in and become an expert on the varied landscape of microgrids.